Hello, my name is Doug Fowler. For 25 years, I have been helping businesses solve complex technical problems utilizing technology. For many years, I specialized in designing and implementing security solutions for complex ERP, HCM, and SCM scenarios, earning industry certification and have been recognized by my peers as an expert in this area. Are you at risk? Worldwide, your data is under attack, whether it's in your own data center or in the cloud, by internal employees or external hackers. Ransomware attacks on governments increased last year by 1,885%. These attacks continue across all businesses and agencies, putting your data, your business in the crosshairs. How can we fight back? Oracle's HCM advanced control to find and eliminate things like ghost employees, duplicate user records, unauthorized salary and compensation changes, payroll errors, and more. For example, this tool can help you find HCM transactions where a single user has updated an employee's salary and personal payment method, or updated an employee's payroll and bank account information. Now, we all know what kind of disaster that could have as far as being able to hire an employee, a ghost employee, fictitiously, you know, set them up and then pay them like you normally would with any payroll. Those are the type of things we're trying to eliminate. Oracle's advanced HCM controls is part of a suite of tools designed to continually monitor HCM transactions to find and eliminate ghost employees, duplicate records, unauthorized salary and compensation changes, payroll errors, and more. Put controls and monitoring in place to prevent such transactions from taking place. Audit those rules and continuously report on any violations that are introduced into your system. Today, we are going to look at the software from the perspective of an internal auditor, Philip Kent. Now, keep in mind that all of the roles and responsibilities can be broken down and delegated to the appropriate people within your organization. Once logged in as the auditor, Philip sees a simple homepage that allows him to access all of the applications, as well as viewing infolets to help manage his compliance activities. Scrolling down a bit, he sees quick action tasks. They're listed to help promote managing tasks that need to be addressed. By clicking on one of these tasks, he will quickly be taken into the application that's required to address the required action at hand. If you continue scrolling down, the analytics at a glance are available. These are referred to as infolets. Infolets are key performance indicators that can be configured to determine critical issues that may require his attention. He sees a number of infolets related to compliance activities that were configured using the risk management cloud products. In this example, Philip turns his attention to the pending incidents. By clicking on the arrow in the corner of the tile, he can flip the tile over for more information. Each infolet is an individual report that delivers instant insight into the data that is important to Philip and provides guided navigation to more detail in order to take action. Now, Philip checks the detail of the pending incidents and sees that he has several segregation of duty incidents that need to be reviewed. If we scroll back up to the top, we can navigate into a more detailed risk dashboard showing what is going on. So dashboards compile all of the relevant data about a subject into a single viewing space. As we scroll down, we can see that they can be interactive to allow you to drill into more details. They can summarize and evaluate critical KPIs. They can compare data to help you focus on critical issues. They can give you updates on different statuses. They can even help you make predictions. Now, in order to address his pending incidents, Philip navigates to the advanced controls to have a look at the model and its results. He is taken to the advanced controls overview page where he can review the controls that have been implemented and the results of the reactive audit. Philip navigates to review the models. Now, Oracle's advanced controls delivers thousands of pre-built controls that are ready to use, accelerating deployment and increasing the return on your investment. These controls can be deployed quickly to automate monitoring financial and HCM transactions, particularly checking for segregation of duty issues. Philip views the advanced control models. The library of controls is based on business's best practices and over a decade of customer experience to help expedite time to value. Organizations might configure and tailor pre-built controls to enforce business policies and align with their risk and their controls. They can determine scope, materiality, the type of criteria they want to search and monitor against without having to know the underlying table or transaction detail and with no coding involved. So Philip wants to go in and check on the segregation duty issues involved with HCM. He can easily filter the control, press the find button to find the specific controls that he's looking for. Now, each control can be scheduled to run periodically or run manually on demand. Advanced controls are part of Oracle's risk management cloud. They are powered by Oracle's adaptive intelligent technology to provide efficient analysis and monitoring of HCM and financial transactions. Advanced controls are built using business-friendly design workbench. Business users can modify existing controls or author new controls using over 1,300 pre-integrated data elements, representing all of the fields available on the screen for each transaction. Those fields can become criteria to design control definitions. Users can leverage a wide range of advanced statistical functions and big data capabilities to uncover suspicious transactions. If we click into more details, in our example, the model detects users generating both payroll and managing person events, things like entering in time and labor. These events, essentially defined as a group of actual HCM transactions, for instance, in this case, managing time, the event will be detected if they click on the create time card, transfer time information in, generate time card transactions. Any of these listed up here are access points that will trigger the event that's to take place. After running the model, Philip can then view the results for more detail. Now, the UI limits the results to 500 lines, and anything over that limit is considered, you need to go in and fine tune your model to get more specific results. In this case, you're seeing there's 5,000 results that are coming back. So Philip can view the results instantly to review the suspected results or fine tune the control, if this number is too large. So auditors are faced with challenging decisions around designing controls, and this will help them identify high value incidents efficiently. Philip can go in and build and test and refine these models until they are to the working model that is desired. Once it's finalized, he can then lock it down and publish it as a control. Now, these finalized models are deployed as controls to further prevent any future changes, and this also allows him to ensure the integrity of his audit. Philip can then define how often it should run and who should be notified of any suspicious transactions. Now, a key part of the advanced controls is the management of the incidents that are detected. Advanced control gives the ability to change assignments, gather comments, and attach any documents that are needed to prove that an incident was properly addressed. So let's drill into this in a little more detail. So when there's too many results, obviously that we were seeing 5,000 of these, let's filter this down to a specific use case. Let's take a look at Brian Joseph. Now, the filtered data is now shown for a single employee. We see that there are 203 incidents being reported around Brian Joseph. So if we drill into this a little bit deeper, I can highlight just several of these rows, and I can take a visual comparison of what's happening for clues as to why this incident is occurring. When I click on the icon to turn this into a graphical view, it creates this graphical workbench that's very efficient for spotting segregation of duty issues and how to go in and remedy these. Now, where two paths intersect, this is typically where a person is getting conflicting responsibility from two or more roles. If we change the display of this orientation to a horizontal display, and then zoom in on the data, we can actually see that it looks like Brian has privileges in both the time and labor and in payroll. Now, one of these should get revoked in order to resolve the segregation of duty issue. So this is just one of the tools that we have to help us analyze these types of conflicts and complex scenarios. So if we go back out to our main menu, another part of the Oracle Risk Management Cloud is access certification. Advanced access controls and access certifications are designed to work together. So access certifications are typically used to conduct and document certifications, or to also document ongoing recurrences of excessive access. It's going to keep track every time you run the audit controls. It's going to track this information so that you can work through step by step on how to go in and resolve the issues that are being presented. The advanced access controls they're specifically designed around detecting of segregation of duty conflicts and the access that personally identified information is being presented to others in case there's an issue there. Any analysis needed to optimize security design are going to come through the access controls, along with alerts whenever there's security changes, increased risk, or conflict in any of the policies. So this approach is faster to adopt and maintain thanks to the integration with HCM and ERP. Direct access to live data is provided since all users, roles, duties, and privileges are all in the same application and all utilize the same user interface and maintenance. So access certifications help ensure the appropriate access by your users. This is also used to support the efforts around Sarbanes-Oxley. For most companies, it's an inefficient spreadsheet and email-driven process to maintain any type of SOX compliance. Automating the certification process drives efficiency while increasing certification accuracy, the effectiveness, and how we can improve the compliance and reduce the risk. An administrator can set up and manage a periodic certification process. They can go in and manage changes to personnel and processes as they occur. This is real time. This is a proactive approach to a problem that when we're dealing with it in a reactive type of mode, sometimes that may be too late. You know, the problem may have been introduced a month ago and somebody's had the ability to go in and make changes over a month, where if we approach it from a proactive approach, anytime a change is introduced into the system that's going to add risk, it's going to immediately notify, you know, the proper authorities to go in and change this, or actually prevent those type of changes from being even introduced into security. So let's go in and take a look at the Q4 for fiscal year 21, hire to retire. So administrators and owners are only going to see the certifications that are real time to them. Philip can only see what he is allowed to see. If he wants to go in and review the progress of a certification, he can click on that, and it will drive in and show him the certification process that he as an auditor is entitled to. Once the certification has been completed and all of the records are set to approved or removal of the status, then the report can be approved by the owner and finalized by the administrator. At this point, the administrator can then notify the security administrator about access that must be removed. So changes can be made in the security console, and then the next time that the audit is run, these issues will the incidents will no longer show up. So Philip has also been designated as an auditor for this hire to retire campaign. So let's take a look at how he would go about resolving and approving a specific asset access certification. So he can go in and add any type of notes, approval information, comments. So any attachments that are certifying as to why this particular incident is valid, or acts of remediation that are being taken to resolve this, can all be documented so that there is a clear process that's being followed. The documents can be attached. We can go in and enter a comment in, and this will allow for that remediation to take place. So with Oracle's HCM advanced controls continually monitoring data, you can rest easy knowing that your data is being protected. Elire has the expertise to help your company with all of your Oracle HCM and ERP needs, including ongoing managed services. Let us help you with your journey to the cloud or with any of the bumps and roadblocks that you have run into. Keeping your data safe and functional is our goal. Thank you for your attention, and have a great day.